Hey guys, Joe here for Premier Basics, a weekly channel where we teach you a... Oh, that was weird. Oh well, where we teach you all the ins and outs of This seriously needs to stop. How the heck do I fix this? Well, I'm here to help because today I will teach you how to fix the most common crashes and errors in Premiere Pro. Now keep in mind guys, I'm just an editor. I don't actually work at Adobe, so I don't have a solution for every Premiere problem because there are a lot. But on that note, let's go ahead and fix some issues. Now a first tip to avoid getting crashes is to enable software-only encoding. And you can do this by going to File, Project Settings, General, and under the first option, which is Video Rendering and Playback, you can set the renderer to software only. Now, although this may help a lot of people avoid getting Premiere crashes, it will most likely also slow down the speed of Premiere, depending on your computer specs, of course. So make sure that you think about this because you'll have to choose between either crashes or a slow working Premiere. Now, another tip, if you're editing in Premiere, don't do too much other stuff. If you're downloading the entire One Piece series in the background, then it's most likely that Premiere will have some problems going fast and steady. So make sure to focus only on Premiere Pro when you're editing, especially when your computer isn't that strong. Next one is deleting media cache files. This is completely safe, and since some of them can be corrupted, I highly recommend deleting these from time to time. Now you can do this by going to the Edit menu, Preferences, Media Cache, and then select Clean Unused in the Media Cache database. Now, this will not delete the ones that you're currently using, and there is a possibility that it may not delete the corrupt ones. So what I also recommend is setting an automatic delete option for when they are older than a week, so 7 days. Now my next tip, saving and auto-saving. Make sure that you get the habit of pressing Ctrl S a lot. And from the Edit menu, Preferences, Auto-save, select a time period on which Premiere has to save automatically. I usually set this around 5 minutes. So when I'm not doing anything or when I'm gone to the toilet, I'm sure that it will save. So when I come back and it crashes, I still have a file that's very recent. Okay, but those tips are quite logical, right? Now let's dive into some real problems now. Oftentimes you will get an error when you apply a warp stabilizer and then another effect or a speed ramp. Now, warp stabilizer is quite beefy and it can't properly work with a speed ramp or some other effects. So to get rid of this stupid error, simply just nest the clip whenever you apply a warp stabilizer to it. And that will already solve the issue. Next error, the typical and oh so lovely crash report. You're just editing, nothing special, and then suddenly, kaboom! Crash, out of nowhere, without a reason. Well, there is a solution that can work. Not always, but oftentimes. So you go into the Explorer, you locate the PC driver, then hit Documents, Adobe, Premiere Pro, select the version that you're currently using, and then select everything inside that folder and hit Delete. And this will actually reset Premiere Pro, and oftentimes this helps because for some reason Premiere just forgets why it's always suddenly crashing out of the blue. Now, like I mentioned, it doesn't always work though. So what you can also do is try to uninstall Premiere and reinstall it. The next one, error compiling movie. Now, this is an error that I have experienced quite a lot. You try to export your video, which has no problem playing back in the timeline and whatever. And then suddenly, out of nowhere, halfway through the export, or maybe sometimes even almost at the end, kaboom! Error compiling movie. No information at all what's causing the problem. Only a hint to the timecode where a problem may be occurring. Now what's actually happening oftentimes is your GPU is having a serious leak, making it go crazy. Now I've tried a whole lot of things to get rid of this error, and sometimes either one of them will work, and then from time to time, it's just not working at all. But here are my tips to get rid of this error. First up, export in pieces. And I know it's time consuming, but instead of exporting your video in one piece, just use in and out points to export it in maybe 2 or 3 pieces. Then afterwards, stitch those back together in Premiere and export the entire video. This helps, but not always. So here's another way. Create a new sequence with the exact same sequence settings as the one you have been using, and just copy and paste everything in your timeline into that new sequence. Then export that one, and who knows, maybe it works. Oftentimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. Why? No idea. Just because, well, Premiere. Still not working? Well, here's tip number 3. Instead of creating a new sequence, just create a whole new project, and then import that sequence, or the entire project, into the new project and export it from there. Will it work? Yeah. Will it always work? No. Tip number 4. Restart Premiere or even restart your PC. On to the next tip. Look at the timecode where the problem may have been occurring. Now, if your clips have effects applied to them on that specific timecode, then maybe try to disable the effect and try to export that part once again. If it works, then it means that something is wrong with the effect. What you can do is place an adjustment layer above it and apply it to the adjustment layer instead of the clip itself. Or maybe adjust the effect just a tiny bit. Or try to nest the clip with the effect applied to it. This also works sometimes. And then the next error. Now, when you're suddenly experiencing errors in Premiere that weren't there before, then downgrade to a previous version of Premiere. For example, today I'm using the 14.3.2 version of Premiere, which causes a serious playback problem when you're placing two clips on top of each other. Now, downgrading to 14.3 helps a lot because a problem wasn't occurring in that version. But how do we downgrade? Well, it's super easy actually. We open the Adobe Creative Cloud app, we go to Premiere Pro, select the three little dots on the right side, and then select other versions. And here you get a list of all the other versions of Premiere Pro. Pick the version that you know didn't have the specific issue that you're experiencing, and then hit install. And well, guys, here's a final tip to never, ever get any crashes in Premiere Pro, and that is to... So with that trick, you will never experience any problems anymore. Now, if you're sick of Premiere and want to learn awesome VFX inside After Effects, I have a solution for that. Check out our super awesome beginner After Effects class on Skillshare. Seriously though, I watched it because I sucked at After Effects and now I know all the basics. And the best part is that it doesn't crash as often as Premiere. Woo! So go ahead, click on that link below, get your 2 free months on Skillshare. Oh yeah, you heard me right. 2 freaking months just for free. So go on, click on that link and start watching your class right now. I'll see you guys next week, and as always, stay